In the previous video, we discussed Splunk components. So in this video, we're going to see how these components come together to form different Splunk deployments. Now, let's suppose that you want to purchase Splunk. There are certain factors or characteristics that you have to take into consideration, and these are ultimately going to, you know, determine the kind of deployment type that you get for Splunk. The first one to take into consideration here is how much data that you're going to be ingesting in a day. That is the primary thing to consider because it's proportional to the kind of license that you're going to have. The second one is the number of concurrent users. So maybe you could just have a small company with 10 users. You know, these users are going to be connecting and using Splunk in a day. Or it might be a large organization with hundreds to thousands of users. You have to take that into consideration as well. Another thing to look at is the number and type of searches that you're going to be running. So if you don't have optimized searches in Splunk, for example, they're going to consume a lot of resources. So if you have just basic searches, it's not going to consume resources. So when you look at the type of and number of searches that you're going to be running, that is an important consideration as well. And the last one here is high availability needs. Remember, we spoke about indexer clustering and search head clustering. Right. So if there are things like that as well that you need to take into consideration, do you always want to have access to the same data set? Do you want to be able to search data every time? Those are going to help you determine whether you need to do that kind of clustering. So when you take all these factors and put them together, it determines the deployment type. So what are some of the common deployment types that you see with Splunk? The first one is a single instance deployment. We spoke about this a little bit before. It's also known as a departmental deployment. The second one is what we call a small enterprise deployment. And of course, the largest one is what we're going to call a medium to large enterprise deployment. So in the following slides, we're going to see the characteristics that are associated with these deployment types. Okay, let's start with a single instance or departmental deployment. What are the things that characterize this kind of deployment? The first one is the indexing volume. So for this kind of deployment, you need to have an indexing volume of less than 20 gigabytes per day. So you've looked at all the data that you have and you think that, yeah, in a day, I'm going to be able to ingest something that is less than 20 gigabytes. Then you start thinking about this kind of departmental deployment. And then the second one is to look at the number of forwarders. So it's departmental. Maybe it's just a very small setting where you have just like 10 machines that you want to collect data from and send into Splunk. So you're going to install 10 forwarders, one forwarder per machine, and then you configure this to collect data and send into Splunk. There is a possibility that you can have more than 10 forwarders, but it's recommended to keep it under 100 forwarders, so you should not have more than that. Now, the other thing that we saw is the number of users as well. So it's a small department. Maybe you just have 10 users that are going to be connected at a time, maybe during busy hours and then running searches and doing things in Splunk. Typically, that's the recommended number of users that you have for this kind of deployment. And what does it look like? So as we said, it's a single instance deployment. So a departmental is just like you have a server, maybe a Linux server somewhere, and then you say, I'm going to purchase Splunk, install Splunk on it. It's going to be my indexer and search head at the same time. It has an IP, port number, whatever. I'm going to go configure those forwarders so that they can send that data into the Splunk instance that is associated with that Linux machine. So for the small enterprise deployment, this one is a little bit bigger than the, you know, the departmental or single instance deployment that we saw in the previous slide. The first characteristic here, the indexing volume should be between 20 and 100 gig per day. We saw that single instance is less than 20 gig. So if you are having between 20 and 100 gig per day, then you should start considering a small enterprise deployment. And then the second thing is that you need to have, like, if you are looking at a few hundred forwarders, so maybe between 100 and 200 forwarders, or maybe a little bit more. In that kind of range, you should start thinking, okay, a small enterprise deployment is what is going to fit my needs. And what about the number of users to consider? So here you would typically talk about between 10 and 100 users that are going to be connected concurrently and, you know, running searches and doing things within Splunk. What does a small enterprise deployment look like? It looks something like this. So typically, you are talking 2 to 3 indexers. So you are no longer going to have a single instance deployment where you just have your deployment on one machine and it's functioning as an indexer or a search head. No. So you now have a distributed deployment. Basically, you can have 2 to 3 indexers, and these indexers are going to be on different machines. And then the other thing with the small enterprise deployment is that it's recommended to have a separate search head. So the users that are coming to run searches in Splunk, they're going to be connected through that search head, and then it's going to be communicating with the indexers to get results and display for the users. Okay, so now let's look at the largest ones, the medium to large enterprise deployment. What are the characteristics? The first one here, which is a medium enterprise deployment, the ingest volume is between 100 and 300 gig per day. So you've now moved from 20 gig, and then you went small enterprise from between 20 to 100, and then now you're at medium enterprise, which is between 100 and 300 gig per day. And if you're talking the large enterprise, this will be for large organizations that are going to be ingesting between 300 gig to maybe several terabytes of data per day. And then what's the next thing to talk about again is the number of forwarders. So here it is very easy to have hundreds to thousands of forwarders. That's because, as we say again, this is mostly going to be for large organizations. So for the medium enterprise, for example, it's always in the range of hundreds to a few thousand forwarders. Meanwhile, for the large enterprise deployment is many thousands of forwarders. So basically you have thousands of machines in your network that you need to collect data from there and send into Splunk. Now, what about the number of users? The number of users can go from hundreds to thousands. Again, you all know that these are things that are, you know, going to characterize very large organizations. So if you have a team of experts there, or people that are domain experts, as we said before, that are going to be using Splunk, you know that they all going to be Splunk users, right? And then you know that you can anticipate the number of users that can be connected concurrently in a day and running searches and things like that. And in big organizations, they're always going to be in the hundreds to the thousands. So medium is going to be in the hundreds, and then large is going to be potentially thousands of users. And what does this look like? So again, it's a distributed deployment. And in this case, you are now talking more than three indexes. So you have several indexes. There is no specific number here. That's why it's just listed as indexer 1 to indexer n. It could be 10, it could be 15, it could be 5. It just really depends. And then you can also have indexer clustering. That depends on you. We spoke about data availability or high availability needs. So if you think, for example, that you want to be able to access your data at any time, you can define indexer clusters. But defining clusters as well means that you're going to need more indexes. And then the other thing as well now is you don't have a single search head. So in this case, you're talking of a search head cluster. That is the recommendation that comes with a medium to large enterprise deployment. And this is done because the expectation is you are using Splunk. You don't want to come at some point and then you are unable to search. Because if a search head goes down, you can't do that if you have a single search head, like in the case of a small enterprise deployment. That's why you have to have a search head cluster. And if you have a search head cluster, of course, you're going to have a search head cluster deployer that you're going to use in order to deploy content or apps to the members of your search head. So let's look at two broad categories of deployment architectures that you will often hear people talk about: Splunk Cloud or is it Splunk Enterprise? Let's clarify that difference here. So with Splunk Enterprise, you're saying that your infrastructure is located on your own premises. So the components are installed locally. You own the infrastructure. So the machines on which you are installing Splunk belong to you. They are found on your own premises. That is basically what Splunk Enterprise means. So you're talking about all these indexers you're going to install, the searches you're going to install, and maybe the management components if you're going to have like deployment server, indexer cluster manager, and all this stuff, they are on your premises. Then we are talking Splunk Enterprise. The other one is Splunk Cloud. So remember when we were talking about the certifications for Splunk, we said that there was a cloud admin certification. So you can also have Splunk that is available in the cloud. It's just like you buy a virtual machine in the cloud. You don't really own that infrastructure. So the infrastructure is owned by a cloud provider. And basically, Splunk is being provided or offered to you just as a software, as a service, an SaaS. So you just basically use it. You don't know which machine holds the component. Maybe some machine that is found somewhere. Everything is virtualized. So you basically cannot see that. That's what we call Splunk Cloud. So we have those depicted here again, just for more clarity. For Splunk Enterprise here, you're going to see all your infrastructure is found on your premises. You could have on virtualized infrastructure. It could be virtualized. You have virtual machines, containers, and whatnot. And then all your components are going to be installed on your own premises. And then the handshake with Splunk, you're going to have your software packages, your licenses, services, and whatnot. With the Splunk Cloud, these components are not on the customer premises. So most of them are going to be in the cloud. So you're going to take the Splunk, for example, I think uses AWS and Google Cloud. So you have your virtual machines, the containers, everything is going to be in the cloud and it's not visible to you. So Splunk is only provided to you as a service. You have your indexes and search heads that are out there in the cloud. Now, for forwarders, it's a little bit different. It could be different, let me put it that way, because most of the time, the machines that contain the data that you want to use in Splunk will be located on your own premises. I say most of the time because those machines could also be in the cloud. And then you still have to install forwarders on premises and configure those forwarders to collect data and send the data out to the cloud. So you may maybe take this data from universal forwarders. You might use an intermediate forwarder like a heavy forwarder to get that data into cloud. So there are concepts that come with this as well. And when we're going to be talking about a cloud admin, maybe at some point you're going to get more clarity. So this far, we've discussed the need for Splunk. We've discussed what Splunk is, the components that make up Splunk. We went individually and kind of dived into these components. And we also saw how you can bring the components together to form different deployment types depending on your characteristics. So in the next topic, we're going to start to do the first practical video of this series. So we're going to talk about Splunk installation. We're going to talk about an overview of Splunk installation, how you get your packages, how you install the package, and then we're going to go ahead and demonstrate how you install Splunk on three different operating systems, which are going to be Windows, Linux, and Mac OS.